Hello everyone, I'm Professor Geek. Welcome back to my channel. And today I want to talk about feminism. That sounds fun, huh? I've seen a number of people online resurrect this interview that Gal Gadot did. I think it was right before the Justice League film came out. And she talks about, well, she's quoted in the interview as saying that anyone who isn't a feminist is a sexist. And I wanted to take that sentiment and put it in context, especially today with the rampant feminist agenda that we're seeing just bulldozing all through Hollywood and all over what could otherwise be wonderful stories. And this is justified by people's manipulative way of forcing you to accept that word. They want people to think that they are not allowed in any way to dissent from the use of that word, and they must shrink when that word is brought into play because it's unassailable. You are not allowed to disagree. And I've seen this shared around a bit, and it says, Wonder Woman star Gal Gadot says, anyone who is not a feminist is sexist. This article really, really pisses me off. Now, you'll have to stick around for the whole video to really, really understand what I'm saying and get the entirety of my thoughts and sentiments here. I'm not necessarily pissed off at Gal Gadot. If I'm reading between the lines of this article well enough, I don't think she's necessarily expressing the sentiment that the article's headline is trying to play into, the sensationalism that it's trying to play into. But what really pisses me off is this idea, this bullying idea, that you are not allowed in any way to question this term feminist. I utterly hate the word feminist. I cringe at it. If you ask me if I'm a feminist, I will emphatically and with no hesitation at all tell you absolutely not. And you can piss off straight to hell if you think that makes me sexist. Now, obviously, I'm speaking with some emotion there, and I will tell you why. My experience with that word feminist, every time someone has said I'm a feminist or they've even mentioned the word feminist, this or that, nothing good has come from that. Nothing about just the equality between sexes remotely follows that word feminist in my experience, especially in the academic world. Nothing but a bunch of bitter shrews have tried to bully or tried to insult or degrade or whatever. They're usually angry, and it's just, it's no fun for anybody involved. These people are looking for somebody to hit with their big stick that they carry on their shoulder. They've got a cause, they've got an agenda, they've got this victimhood, and they are looking for somebody to make them pay for it. Now, that is my experience with the word feminist, and you can never take that away. You can't just wave that away with your dictionary definition. I've talked about this before. People make ignorant fools of themselves when they say, well, too bad, this is the definition of the word, so you just have to deal with it. That's how language works. No. Clearly, you don't understand how language works. I've talked about before with terms like comics gate or different things. There are two schools of thought when it comes to language and defining words. There is the prescriptivist, which is, okay, these are the agreed upon definitions. This is the official definition of XYZ word or whatever. And that's what we need to go by. And then there is the descriptivist. And the descriptivist says, it doesn't matter what you prescribe in a book. If people aren't using the words like that, then good for you in your book, but that's not actually how the words are being used. That's not how they are at play. You have to take them as they're used and as they're understood by people. You know, whatever's written in a book, be damned. Now, either of these two schools of thought taken exclusively are obviously going to provide problems. You need to have some sort of measure of both of them. There needs to be obviously some sort of agreed upon definition of words, or else people will just not be able to communicate after a while. Go down the road far enough where this word means something different and suddenly you're not communicating. At the same time, language evolves and the prescribed definitions needs to recognize that and actually take that into account, or else language will no longer serve its purpose of allowing us to express ourselves. It will just be a prescribed way to express the ideas of a previous generation. So I hate the word feminism. And it's not just in the academic world that I see that. I see people, the SJW crowd, using it to beat people over the head with their agendas all the time, over and far beyond anything that has to do with the equality between the sexes. At the same time, I have to recognize, though, that that's my experience. And just as nobody can take that away from me or just simply pretend that it doesn't matter, at the same time, my experience can't define the word for anybody else. So while I will never identify as this word feminist, and I hate it, and I'm never going to describe myself like that, I have to understand that somebody else who pops up who might say that they're a feminist, I can't automatically lump them in with everybody in the world that has ever said they're a feminist to me. I have to give them a chance. I have to ask them about the specifics of what they're saying. Because as I've also said before, the word feminist is a very vague word to the point where it's almost useless. It's kind of like saying you're a Christian. I've given this example before. You can say you're a Christian and mean that you're anything from a fundamentalist, Seventh-day Adventist, a Mormon, a Catholic, a Southern Baptist, a Episcopalian who's very liberal. I mean, all different kinds of belief systems can fall under this term Christian, that you need to be way more specific in your language and your descriptors. And the feminist word is the same, that feminist label. I mean, it goes far beyond just the three, first wave, second wave, third wave. I mean, the people will argue there's a fourth wave, there's intersectional. With each one of those waves, there are different ways that people will argue of applying it. It was quote-unquote feminism that elected Wonder Woman, the fictional character, as the spokesman for the United Nations for women's rights and for little girls, an example to set for them. And it was also quote-unquote feminism that stripped her of her title no more than a few weeks later because, oh, you know, she's so objectified. We can't have something, you know, so sexualized like that. Oh, that's just horrible. Feminism is why we can't have nice things. It's ridiculous. So if I was going to gravitate toward any of them, second wave feminist viewpoints are obviously a little bit more in line with my thoughts and the idea of, yes, there's a difference between the masculine and feminine. There's a difference between men and women. And the feminine is its own beautiful thing, its own beautiful strengths, and deserves to be celebrated in its own right. But I'll usually part ways with people when it comes to the methodology and the practice of that. Gal Gadot in this article seems to be saying really no more than that. She goes a bit far when she says anybody who's not a feminist is a sexist, but I don't really think she's wagging a finger. I didn't get that sense in the article. I think she's speaking from her own experience, and that is fine with me. That makes sense, whatever. She does seem to be more in line with that sort of second wave idea that let's celebrate the feminine, which is the right place to come from if you're going to portray Wonder Woman or talk about Wonder Woman in any kind of feminist terminology. I've done multiple videos on the creation of Wonder Woman and the role that she plays in society psychologically, her origins. Marston created her as an Amazon and the psychoanalytic origins that he imbued her with, being a Jungian psychoanalyst himself. I'll link to those videos in the top right-hand corner. But this insistence that you accept this word feminist, this is a manipulative tactic by the extremist left. They don't want you to be able to question or to dissent in any way from this term feminist. And the way they do that is they throw up their hands and say, hell, it's just about equality of the sexes. Well, why are you so upset about that? No, nope. Everything you think, everything you've experienced, everything anybody's done, nope, that doesn't mean anything. Nope, it's just about equality of the sexes. And that's what they want to tell you so that you can't have any kind of bad dissent or bad taste in your mouth with this word. And then they want to go ahead, and once they've got your absolute consent and agreement, and you're on board with this word in every way, and you're no longer allowed to disagree with it, then they'll paste it over everything they can to try to piggyback your complicitness, to try to piggyback your agreement on all these other films, stories, agendas, activisms, whatever. And one way to rip the mask off of these people who are so militant about this word feminist is to say, okay, well, if feminist just means equality of the sexes, then I'm just a humanist. A humanist just means equality of human beings. So, you know, why stop at the sexes? Why don't we just say we're humanists, we're egalitarians, and we want the equality of whether people are different sexes, are different races, are different orientations, or whatever. We just want people to be treated fairly, period. they will bristle at best. At worst, they will scream and spit all kinds of venom in your face because their entire worldviews are built on the idea that no, women are the victims. More than anybody else in this world, women are the victims. Don't you dare. Don't you dare lump in the term feminism with gender studies. No. Get those queer theorists out of here. No, women are the subject. Women need to be studied, and women need to be the ones who are singled out as the most victimized in society. They will cling to their victimhood with their dying breath. And once you move the conversation in that direction, then you can rip the mask off of these extremists, and you know that you're not just dealing with somebody who has a positive experience with the word feminist and wants to use it to describe something like equality of the sexes. No, then you're dealing with somebody who has an agenda, and they're trying to manipulate you with the use of language. They're trying to bully you into acceptance of it. They're being insincere. I'm reining myself in here a great deal with this topic. I want to keep this video somewhat short. Obviously, this is a much larger topic. I could talk about it at length, but I'll leave it there for right now. It's relevant with all of the propaganda that's being pushed about the Captain Marvel films. I hope this doesn't creep into the new Wonder Woman film. I hope they don't try to, this was used for Captain Marvel. We got to use it for the new Wonder Woman film. Even though I was not a fan of the first Wonder Woman film is in terms of a proper representation of the real iconic character of Wonder Woman. I do have hope for the second film because it's not going to be in that same continuity. It's not necessarily going to be a sequel. And I know that they've been trying their best to move step by step by step away from Zack Snyder's core, his story for that film and the universe that he set it in from the beginning. So I'm hoping this will be that final stride to really set it in an iconic representation. So I'm excited about it. I'm going to give it a chance in that manner, but this will kill it dead in my excitement and my anticipation. I won't even worry about it if this is the tactic that they choose for the marketing of it. That's all I have to say this time around. I'll be back with more reviews, cultural analysis, more live streams. In the meantime, you can check out my own graphic novel on Indiegogo, which unapologetically explores and showcases the beauty and sexiness of the female form and of feminine strength, as you'll see when you read the title. But certainly in no way that I would describe feminist or activist or any of that nonsense. Link is in the description. I'll place the ad at the end of the video. Until next time, keep enjoying and digging deeper into the hero stories you love. Thanks for watching. Do you like comics that are unafraid to portray women as feminine and men as masculine? Do you enjoy being entertained rather than preached to? If so, then you'll love my own graphic novel, currently on Indiegogo. Tales from the Stacks is an anthology series in the vein of The Twilight Zone or Tales from the Crypt. It contains three uncanny tales to thrill and haunt you long after reading. With interior art by Dave T and variant covers by John Malin, Kyle Ritter, and Kyung Lee, you have lots of options to choose from. You can find the link in the description below or search Indiegogo for Tales from the Stacks. And tell the comic industry you don't have to settle for their social agenda platforming. Thanks. And last but not least, don't forget that your Professor Geek now has a merch store. Check out the current options from t-shirts to magnets to the iconic Professor Geek coffee mug, and let me know if you'd like to see something else. The link is in the description, or you can go to cafepress.com/professorgeek.